All right guys, today's video is brought to you by Air Guns of Arizona. They officially sponsored this video, so if you like what you see after I'm done shooting this bad boy, go ahead and shoot on over to AOA and get yourself something nice. Where's the rest of it, you might be asking? Don't worry. When these first came out, they had some problems with the stocks snapping in half, mostly due to UPS's conveyor belt. So they started shipping the stocks separately. There's my Huguette right there. Boom, look at that beauty. Super glossy finish. Oh, just beautiful. We got some stippling right there. Wow. Of course, your LED screen fits right through there. Laser etched day state. Wow. So that's it. We got it. It looks like a 3D adjustable butt pad. Cheek riser. That's where you put your battery, right in the bottom there. Boy, stock is probably one of the best things about these. They also have a real carbon fiber shroud, not simulated. And we'll get to all of the rest of the goodies in a second here. Let me put this thing together. Holy crap, you guys, check out the size of this stock screw. Freaking gigantic. All right, here we are. So it's got a 1000 milliamp 5C LiPo battery right there. And this will actually last for thousands of shots. So go ahead and charge that baby up. My box came with a charger. Looks like we got an extended sleeve right there for filling your foster fitting built right into the gun. That's cool. So no fill probe required. Got a super snazzy day state magazine. I think they'll sell for about $100. There's the warranty card right there and a nice manual. We'll get to that in a second.
I got a Huguette moderator for mine.
As well, you guys, it has a little magnetic dust cover for your little doodad there. Woo, nice. All right, let's check this out. Got a warranty registration card. Looks like they tested my gun out for me, did a bunch of checks right there. This is a Day State air rifle test sheet. So I'm looking at 30 foot-pounds in my 177 here. Minimum speed, 915, maximum speed, 920. Oh, that was with a little shot string they did there. Nice. And signed by somebody. Registered in England.
As you can see, it has a really nice full color manual. There's not too much in here. It does tell you that the magazine inserts from the left side, but if you pull out the stop pin, you can make it insert from the right side. Looks like we got auto safety feature, pellet recommendations, programming the rifle, power level adjustment, match trigger adjustment, and we got an exploded view. Very nice if you want to order a part.
The Red Wolf now comes with a 5-year warranty. Close up look at that finish right there. Aluminum's just beautiful. Nice textured finish. We got a nice carbon fiber bottle right here. As I mentioned, the carbon fiber shroud. Here's the other side. Now this lever right here, it indexes the magazine, but it does not cock the gun. Apparently it's super smooth. Oh yeah, look at that. There's like no resistance hardly at all. Dovetail rail on the top there. There of course is your stock adjustment screw. Probably just loosen that up and I think you're gonna have a three-dimensional adjustment. Bam! All right, you guys, let me shoot on over to Air Guns of Arizona and I'll get you some hardcore stats. All right, when these first came out, they were selling for $2,800. Roughly. Now, at the time of this filming, Air Guns of Arizona has these for $23.99.
That's actually for the European version, I call it. The high-power U.S. version is still $27.99. This is kind of like the Ferrari of air guns. Pulsar is actually Daystate's bullpup design, and you can get one of those with all the same electronics as this gun has. So definitely check out the website. There's actually a ton of different Daystate guns for sale over there. This gun also comes in walnut, safari, and one of my favorites, midnight blue. These are available in 177, 22, and 25 caliber in the standard version, and the high power is available also in 30 caliber. The weight on the standard model is 7.5 pounds, with the high power coming in at 8.5 pounds. Standard has a 17-inch barrel, the high power has a 23-inch barrel.
Overall length is 39 inches. I'm sure that's without the Huguette. Carbon fiber tank. And confirming right there, the magazine is $99.
For shot capacity, we have 10 shots in every caliber, except for the 30 caliber, which has a 5-shot capacity. As far as foot-pounds, you're looking at 30 foot-pounds on the high-power 177, 50 foot-pounds on the 25 caliber high-power, 80 foot-pounds in 30 caliber, and get this, the new Safari Edition has 65 foot-pounds in 22 caliber. As well, you can get ART tuning as an option, accuracy research team, and it utilizes a GCU 2.0, which is a new gun control unit, which makes it capable of that extreme power. If you want to know more about the Safari Edition, go ahead and give AOA a call, and they'd be happy to answer any questions for you.
Every now and then, an air gun manufacturer will develop a new rifle that changes the trajectory of the entire industry. The marketplace has recently been privileged to a number of very exciting models with features and designs that have definitely moved the needle on what defies an exciting air gun. Enter the next generation and new air gun benchmark of the Daystate Red Wolf. The Red Wolf and Red Wolf HP is the Formula One of air rifles with computer and state-of-the-art MTC firing systems. Each Red Wolf has three individual programmed energy and velocity settings that can be selected by the shooter in seconds. The shooter can further tune the rifle with the optional Daystate programmer within these rifle limits. The programming unit is $399 if you want to really tweak your gun. This feature is not for the faint of heart, as it allows each power level program to be manipulated to achieve the very best speed for a given pellet out of each individual rifle. Daystate has thoughtfully included a default program if the user wants to return to the factory settings. The Red Wolf's LCD screen displays the state of the air pressure in tenths of a bar. The battery state, shot count, total number of shots fired, magazine counter, and more. The heart of the waterproof computer controlled system is the electronic MTC. This firing valve takes pressure readings from the carbon air supply and tells the valve how much to open in order to give the maximum shots per fill and tight shot consistency for bench rest winning accuracy from the special select barrel. The battery to power the unit is conveniently stored in the easy to access grip area, and it will provide thousands of shots before a recharge is required. There is no finer trigger on a sporting air rifle than the fully tunable match grade unit on the Red Wolf. The trigger can be set to break on a breath or set for sporting applications as needed. The action of the Red Wolf is left or right hand reversible super glide side lever that requires almost no effort. So that's awesome. You can change your charging handle from right to left. The action is fast and positive for quick follow-up shots or arthritic hands. The Red Wolf sports an improved 10-shot magazine and carbon fiber shroud system to reduce report. All that is the Red Wolf is cradled into the finest sporting air gun stock Daystate has ever created. to present a piece of air gun artwork. Elegance is not wasted as the stock provides cheek piece adjustments for height, left and right canting, as well as butt pad up, down, left and right. The Red Wolf, with two available power configurations and world-class design and performance specifications, will set the standard for sporting class air rifles. The luxury choice for target hunting and field use. Sounds good to me.
So to program the rifle, you open the bolt. So pull that charging handle back. And then you want to hold the trigger down for 5 seconds. That'll get you to programming mode. Now you're going to use the trigger to toggle through a few different choices. The first one is magazine on and off. Now once you select a choice, you have to close the bolt back up and reopen it to get to a different one.
As per Daystate's recommendations, make sure that you engage the safety before you open the bolt and start the programming procedure.
So you can see here I turned the magazine on, and that just means that it's going to count down 10, and then on the 10th shot, it'll disable the gun. So if you're doing single shot mode and you don't want the gun to turn off every 10 shots, then you have to turn the magazine off. Now if I open the bolt again, I can cycle through and find my power level, and here I'm going to stick it on power level high. And when you're done selecting your power level, you just close the bolt again. And that's pretty much all this LCD screen does. It's not a huge computer or anything. It just has a few simple things in there, like power level setting and magazine on and off.
That's a pretty good shot right there, huh? 35 yards. That's with a 16 grain JSB Beast 177. The only thing though, that's not a shot. That's a group. That's a 3-shot group at 35 yards. All right. And I did it more than once. So I just sighted in and this gun was so much fun, I couldn't stop shooting it. 3 shots. Every single one of these is 3 shots. And this is just the first time I shot this gun ever. I just sighted it in and didn't even fill the tank back up. Just kept on shooting all the way down to about 170 bar. And got a lot of great groups there. Definitely. So, I'll do it again for you guys. Alright guys, this is when I started out, and then on this row I made another click. I think I went down a little farther, and anyway, and this is the row where I got perfectly sighted in, and this is 15 shots. These are groups of 3 shots each, so you can see my last two groups. Look at that. I can barely fit the 177 caliber pellet through that hole of 3 shots. So this is only the second time I've shot this, and already contest winning accuracy at 35 yards. This is some 35 yard accuracy testing that I filmed before I discovered that the rifle had not been cleaned. Perfect, 35 yards away.
So it's still not bad for a gun that still has the preservative junk in the barrel.
35 yard accuracy testing right now. So get up to here, see where we're hitting on the shooting see right here. Red Wolf, baby. So three it is. We're going to do three shot groups on all these little guys.
So this gun was pretty much punching out the ten ring just a couple days ago, and now it's more doing cloverleaf patterns. So I thought something might be up. Mr. Googly Eyes here should have been the first indicator that something might be wrong. So just on a hunch, I decided to run a patch through this. Here's what happened. Got some ballast all right there.
You normally never need to clean an air gun, except for when it's brand new.
Before you shoot it, you should clean it one time.
You dirty dog.
Looks like they didn't clean it. I got this from a friend who hadn't shot it yet, but I just assumed it had been cleaned. Guy's a high quality barrel. It comes clean on the first swipe, and that's pretty much what happened here. So I'm going to run through a few dry patches. You don't want to use hops to clean air guns because that rots the seals. Ballistol is safe for your air gun seals. There's a link in the description below if you want to order one of these. This one's called a Crown Saver.
Also, never use a metal cleaning rod on an air gun.
Now that's more like it.
This was some 50-yard shooting that I did before I cleaned the rifle.
Alright, I got a groundhog poking through the grass right there. Let's take care of it. Smurfic.
This is more 50-yard shooting with the same 16.2 grain JSB pellets.
See that? I just shot that battery's hat off. So if I went down there and greased these targets up, well, there we go. We got one up by hitting it lower.
Get the other one up. Boom. So I was
picking where I wanted to hit. Now we'll take two headshots on the chicken, see if we can get two headshots.
They'll both go down. downtown, Julie Brown.
Guys, look where I nailed that battery right where I was aiming. Holy crap. Perfect shot.
So the guy that sold me this gun a couple years ago, he had to pay his taxes really fast, so I got a great deal on it. I got this Aztec Emerald scope for free with it, and I got 8,000 brand new tins of JSB pellets, so 4,000 of each of these. This Aztec first focal plane scope pairs really well with the Red Wolf. Great combination. They sell this scope and a lot of other cool ones at Air Guns of Arizona. So check them out if you want to see more about these scopes.
Here's some accuracy testing that I did from 50 yards away.
16 green grain JSBs. Let's see, I'm just going to sight in right here. And we'll see what's going on.
And once again, it's with a dirty barrel, but it shot pretty good.
Let's see if I can just use this dot to, like, sight in.
Should be as simple as that. Alright guys, I think I just clicked down for the proper elevation. Let's get this party started. Alright, I think that's about 10 shots. So here's that target, guys. 10 shots. Fits under a dime. And there's the magic pellet right there. JSB 16.2 grains. Packing a punch and flying straight. So guys, that's excellent accuracy, you know. That's the first time I tried that. Just sat down 50 yards, clicked in from the 35 yard, sighting it in, and boom. First try, I got 10 in a dime. So you could get even better groups than that with a little bit of practice. Oh yeah, and that was shooting with a dirty barrel as well. Let's move on to 75. Alright guys, I had to just throw my scope cam back on here because this was so cool. So I was shooting at 50 yards and, you know, those chickens that I got, I was hitting them in the head or all over. It was really fun. And on the first try, I got that hole right there. Okay, and then the second try, I reset it, and I haven't missed yet. I've taken 4 shots. Watch this.
Well, scope cam's being a stinker today.
Well, you guys can kind of see what's going on. And does not miss that 75 yards.
Doesn't seem like it's windy, but I had to click for windage, I think. There we go.
75 yards, hitting where I want to hit. Now it's time for the chicken. I'm not perfectly sighted in, or I could probably hit that. Boom. This right here is an auto-reset squirrel that he came apart. Oh, he still works. That's cool. You see that? So yeah, we got the wind blowing too. All day long you can do this. See if I can get that auto reset bore. I hit it, didn't reset. The bore has an auto reset pedal that's like 1 inch. It's a little smaller than usual. Reset it. Now watch this. Every time. So a dirty barrel on this Red Wolf didn't seem to slow it down one bit.
There's those shots on the 1.5-inch paddles. Pretty good.
You guys can see at 75 yards, the pellet grouping on these steel targets, all the pellets are touching. Look at that. So I'm nailing the bunny right there. He doesn't want to pop back up though. He just doesn't want to stay up. No way it's going to miss this size target at 75 yards. Smacking him with the 16 grain.
Nice day for shooting, huh, Bugaboo?
Hell yeah!
Look at this, you guys. This day state is so shiny you can see the trees and sky reflected in the finish. See that right there? Same thing as the window right there.
Alright, I gotta wrap this video up. It's getting a little long, so real quick, here's the trigger pull. Coming in at a sleek 8 to 9 ounces.
You know you're breaking the sound barrier when you got your LDC on and it still sounds like this. So here is 13 grain with a moderator on high power.
Of course, with the different power levels and different pellet weights, there's like endless possibilities to the power level and the noise level of this gun. The low power setting on this gun is not actually low power. It's a few bumps down from high and medium, basically allows you to slow your pellet down a little bit. It's packing a punch though, and even on low with 7 grain pellets,
7.33 Rally Sport,
it's breaking the sound barrier. My Red Wolf would shoot perfectly until exactly 195 bar. Every single time. So here's a shot string of about 50 shots. You guys will see what happens at about 195. We're using 16 grain JSB Beast pellets for this test. I did start this shot string with a full 249 bar. I actually ended up getting 70 good shots out of this tank.
So right at exactly 196 bar, the velocity went from 950 plus to 935. And then it stayed in the 930s.
Hell yeah!
You can see there's like no wind at all.
So I really want to do a whole card and either punch out the chain ring and all the little targets, or at least have all the pellets touching. So I was not quite able to do that, but I got pretty close. No problem.
So I feel like practicing with the Red Wolf every day raises my skill as a shooter. Because obviously, let me see, 3 times 12, 36 shots. Obviously, I can't make 36 shots perfectly like I did those 3. But maybe someday I will. This is only my second day of shooting it. So at least I know that if I do have one that goes outside, that it's probably me. Let's see, like that one right there. At least I know that's me and not the gun. So there's room for improvement, and you're not wasting your time by practicing. Would you agree, Bugaboo?
Hell yeah!
Alright, it's time for me to skedaddle. Thanks for watching this Red Wolf review. Be sure and shoot over to AOA. Check out all the great stuff they got over there. Once again, guys, thanks for watching. We'll see you on the next one.